Well, again, I just thought, let's have a little fun. It's Halloween. Everybody's gets into the whole thing with candy and costumes and all that, which is always a great thing. I know I was out this past weekend. I saw Delilah was out. Tina, I saw you were out. Handy, what did you do anything this past weekend, Handy? Did you go, man?
I went to Memphis to go. My mom had back surgery on Wednesday, so I went to Memphis to check on her.
Well, then I hope everything is good with mom, right? I hope everything is good with mom and the back surgery.
I got mom home from the hospital, and it took me an hour to convince her. Man, mom is going to be mom. She's like, no, I got to make sure I do such and such. And I need you to go do this, and I need you to go do that. And yeah, my mom is, don't worry, mom is fine. Trust me.
She's good. All right. There you go. All right. Awesome. Well, I'm glad to hear that. I'm glad that that was successful. So here we go. As we've come to the last segment that we have for every show. And I thought we'd maybe do something a little different for our one last thought this week. So we are going with our favorite Halloween memory. And again, being that it's Tuesday and we had a show today and it is Halloween, at least for another 2 hours and 48 minutes. So, Handy, we'll go ahead and start with you, my friend. What is your favorite Halloween memory, if you can, if you have one or a couple or whatever? Let's see what you got.
It's gonna be really stupid. It was. I mean, every kid's dream. We're all of an age around kind of the same age.
Sure.
Yeah,
we're all within 10 years of each other, basically. So, yeah.
And there was one thing that meant more to kids, at least, I don't know about little girls, but little boys more than anything else about the Halloween costume. It had to have a cape. You had to be with a cape.
Sure.
I used to bug my mom, can we please go get costumes early so that we can get one? She was like, I need costumes, cost too much damn money. And a little bit, I know back then that I mean, at 9 or 10, I was like, okay, mom, $7 is a lot of money. But like, I'm like, yo, 7 off the break, brand new, gimme. But she would always wait till like the day before or day of even to get something so that, you know, she wouldn't have to pay a whole $7 for a brand new Halloween costume. I'm paying $7 for something you're gonna wear one time, throw away. So,
right.
So not only that year did my mom get me the costume with the talking mouth, it had a cape. I forgot what hero it was. I don't even think it was like a Marvel or a DC hero. It just had a moving mouth and a cape.
And a cape.
I did not care about candy that year. I don't care how much I had. I had a costume with a cape. I think I fought with my mother to get her to let me sleep in it because I had a cape. Because November 1st, I was gonna hang it up in my closet, and then I was gonna come home from school, and it was gonna be gone out with the trash. That and one of the things that I used to love about Halloween was, leading up to Halloween, the local TV affiliate used to put on all the old school horror movies, the Bela Lugosi, Frankenstein, Bela Lugosi. And I can't think of his name, but he played like the Lon Chaney Jr., who played the book.
Phantom of the Opera, all that. Yeah.
Phantom of the Opera, The Thing, The Blob. There was a 3D movie, a black and white 3D movie called The Mask. And the local 7-Eleven chains were like, you get a free set of 3D glasses with your... Like that was, and it was a big deal for us. Every Halloween, it would start like 10 days out. And so on the weekends, we were allowed to binge watch all these movies. So that was, you know, and while we snuck Halloween candy that we weren't supposed to be eating because my mom was supposed to be giving it out. So those are my two big Halloween memories. Now, what I didn't like about Halloween was when I got grown and I started being a karaoke DJ. And the bars would be like, we only gonna pay you $150 to DJ for Halloween, but they were giving out $1,000 in the costume contest.
Right, exactly. Right. You're like, come on, man. What is that?
$1,000? Where were you doing these costume contests?
Right.
Up near DC.
I was like, okay.
$1,000 costume contest. Yeah, that's a lot of money for a costume. All right, hey, whatever works.
I'm just saying, you can't make first prize five and maybe break your boy off at five.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, right, right. I'm used to that. Usually $1,000 player. Oh, you were like snooty places because that's the place that do like the. Really? No. Okay.
They really wanted people to go out for it if they were giving away $1,000. I mean, some places,
some of the like the smaller places were giving away like 100 or 200, maybe three.
Right. On
the
top That's end. What I'm used to.
But there were a couple of places that would give out like well, okay, to be fair, this the place that gave away the grand was in Ashburn, Virginia, which is right around the corner from Redskins Park. A lot of people with money. I'm sorry, Commander's Park. Right. So there's a lot of people right there with money. But yeah, some of them, and it used to piss me off. It's like, this is one of the most popular DJ nights of the year.
Yes.
You only gonna pay me 150 to two, but you have $1,000. Always tell me you don't have no money. But you're giving out $1,000. You're gonna give $1,000 to whatever girl can shake her accoutrements really well in her Halloween costume.
Accoutrements.
Right. Accoutrements. There you go. Yes, the ever popular accoutrements that women wear on their costume.
Yeah, that was a 1950s rock band.
Yeah, exactly. There you go. All right, Tina, how about you? What are your favorite Hollywood Halloween memory? I can talk.
I hate to say it, but I'm gonna be like Candy. I've got two. One, my love of Halloween parties and doing all of that, and I think my love of just parties in general come from my parents because they always had Halloween parties. But I remember being like 14, 15, like 7th, 8th, 9th grade. And being like, my parents had their Halloween party and they were like, invite all your friends over. And so I got to see a lot of drunk adults for like 4 hours.
Right, exactly. Yes.
And so, yes, like, so true. They came up with and stuff. So I kind of got to, that was the love. But one of my favorites is my mom, like I said, we were talking like Halloween comes from my mom. My mom loved Halloween. She loved doing costumes and stuff. And she always took time to figure out, like, one year I went as an Illini cheerleader and she found like the right color, everything to match it up with cheerleader costume. Because of course at that time, we all remember school, we had the costume contest. Our little kids won the costume contest. One year she did an elephant costume that I wish I could have, I have pictures of, I'm sure she does. But it was like the full head with the ears that stuck out and had the nose hand down wrapped around, stuffed everything. But I remember it rained, it snowed and rained that year when we were going out. So we're walking around like this because it's central Illinois. It's cold outside. Yeah. But every time we would go somewhere, and she sewed a bag, a little mini miniature one size bag of Planters peanuts to the nose, and everybody went in the small town that we lived in. They're like, I've got peanuts. I'm going to give you peanuts too.
Oh, wow. Wow. There you go. Sounds
place. Fun though.
Hey,
that was a fun there you costume. Go. So that's the kind of thing is where I get my thing from. So yeah, kudos to mom on the costumes and the fun of that.
Sounds great. All right, Delilah, how about you? Favorite Hollywood man? Why I keep saying Hollywood? Halloween. It's Halloween, Nick. It's not nothing to do with Hollywood. Halloween memories.
I mean, just a little bit, the movies, right?
No, right. It's a little dramatic, but yeah.
No, my favorite memories are honestly trick-or-treating, doing the Halloween parades in school where they would like actually let you kind of walk around and show off. Like, I feel like, you know, when you're a kid, Halloween is so much fun, especially in public school, because that's when they let you like wear your costumes. Of course, they don't let you wear like certain things, which I understand. Like, but still, you get to show off and be creative and like have a good time. And it's just, I remember the innocence of it. And you're just kindergarten through eighth grade, doesn't matter. Everybody's doing some sort of Halloween party. It's just a fun day of just arts and crafts, because, and now as a teacher, I get it. The kids ain't gonna pay attention, so you just kind of create like, we're gonna have a party, we're gonna color pumpkins, we're gonna, like, you know what I mean? Like,
Exactly. No, I got totally. Because, yeah, absolutely.
And it's like, and that was just so much fun. And yes, even though I'm in Chicago and I remember a lot of rainy, cold, snowy Halloweens, it was still fun because you didn't feel it. So kudos to my parents for dealing with that.
And taking us out.
That's what I mean, taking us out. Thank you to the parents in the cold weather areas today.
Yeah.
Not just the, but anybody in the cold weather areas that are trudging through the snow, the cold, the rain, like kudos to your fortitude. I know you're drinking hot cocoa. You probably go home and have some hot toddies, some wine at the end of the day. The other thing I remember, and it's because we grew up like in the 80s and 90s with like all like the razor panics, you remember? And it came out that it was like there was no validity to it, but your parents, you couldn't even eat your candy, okay? So it's
they
a fun,
x-rayed it.
Yeah,
hospitals will let you come and x-ray it.
So it's a hilarious time too, because I remember my parents, I'm coming home with loot, okay? Kids, we didn't have like these fancy like baskets. Like, I remember trick-or-treating with, like, grocery bags, pillowcases.
Pillowcases. And like, you had an extra one shoved in your closet.
Yeah, because we were going crazy. And this was also, and I feel so sad that businesses don't do trick-or-treating anymore. But, like, you used to go to, like, the business districts, and they would, like, give out, like, the best candies, you know.
Yeah.
As soon as you found out, like, they're giving, like, giant candy bars, you were like, I'm going over there. Like, and that's the part that I remember is even though our families go separately, you would run into your friends, and then you would share the secrets, like, who has the best candies, and la, la, la. And, you know, and then as you got older, the tricks happened more than the treats, although I never participated because I would get in trouble because I am Zennial Latina girl, and so I got, you know, I'd lose everything. So I was like, nah, you guys go TPing and do whatever because I can't lose my privileges.
No, but I get that.
Yeah, and then as I got older, I appreciated all the parties. So in my 20s, I was one of those women that get made fun of, which is kind of sad, but you see them freezing their butts, and it's like, yeah, you know what? Yes, I was one of those dumb girls up there. It's too short stuff, freezing my tuchus so I could participate in all the Halloween parties. But you know what? I had a damn good time. All right. Yes. Did I freeze? Did my feet hurt? Yes.
Yes.
But I had a darn good time. Okay.
There
I
you
don't
go.
Regret right. any of my infamous young adult. To
20
Halloween parties.
Sure, yeah, no,
I got a stress fracture in my foot.
A stress fracture versus
the shoes that work, not the shoes that are comfortable.
Wow,
stress fracture. I love Halloween, basically in all the stages, from childhood to like craziness. Now I'm more like, I'll have a beer, I'll dress up, and then I'm going home. You know what I mean? Like, you know,
for
like,
sure.
That's my Halloween now.
No, 100%. And, you know, that's the thing is, like, Anthony talked about, like, the costumes with a cape. You know, as a child, I was a huge Kiss fan. So, I was 8 years old. And we went through the store, and I'm like, that's it. I found the one. It was a Paul Stanley costume with the, you know, the, like Anthony said, the mask with the little hole in the mouth.
Yeah.
And it had the star on the eye and the whole thing. Like, I'm like, that is the costume I want. And I wore that thing for like 2-3 years in a row because I was such a Kiss fan. I'm like, I gotta have this Paul Stanley costume. I mean, that was probably one of the like earliest memories of like remembering like Halloween like that, like you said, because our neighborhood, you know, back then it just seemed like all the families participated on your block. Everybody had candy, all the kids dressed up, the parents were all out, the kids were all out. You'd go through your neighborhood. Like, it was just such a good time to me. Such great memories, like you said, of just being with the other kids in the neighborhood. You know, like you said, getting to wear your costume to school, having all that. You'd have your little Halloween party, like, in your class. And everybody would bring, like, a little something, you know. And, again, I'm not knocking anybody for anything. And I understand, you know, things are – But we didn't worry about, you know, like the kids who couldn't have peanuts or the kids who couldn't, you know, like the gluten-free thing. Like, you just brought all the candy. Everybody ate tons of lollipops, chocolate, whatever it was, and just had a good time. And it was just fun. It was just a good time. What'd you say?
Circus peanuts.
I never liked those. Mary Jane. I'm not going to like those big old orange, like, circus peanuts. I never liked those. She's like, well, you haven't tried, you know. Oh, by the way, just for the record, I gotta ask you guys this because I'm curious. I am not a fan at all of candy corn. Where do you guys stand on the candy corn? I have to know.
Send it to my house.
Delilah's 50-50, it looks like.
You saw my face. Come on.
Tina totally doesn't like candy corn. What'd you say, Andy?
No, send it to my house right along with the fluffed marshmallow pumpkins. I love both of them.
Yeah.
Wow. But Delilah, what were you saying? You had 50-50?
I'll eat a handful. Like, it's not like I never eat, you know, but it's not my go-to. I'm a Reese's peanut butter cups kind of gal.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Or Snickers.
That's my go-to.
Snickers is my personal favorite. Snickers is number one in my book.
Peanut butter cup anytime, and I'm there. Okay. Yeah. That's my thing. Am I gonna like poop on candy corn?
I hope not. That's just plus that you know what you just ruined, and then on top of that, you done ruined the nutritional value.
I'm just like, am I go-to? No.
Yeah. Candy corn is nutritious, just like actual corn. No, I'm kidding. Anyway,
but then real corn.
Candy corn is always everybody always has that argument of like, oh, can you like candy corn? So I just thought I would ask you guys how you felt about candy corn because I don't like it at all. It's just some people love it. And I'm just like, why? If I wanted to eat wax, I would just go eat a crayon or something. Like, why do I want candy corn?
What's
Peeps at Easter. Yeah. You either love them or you hate them.
Right. What's everybody's go-to Halloween candy?
Snickers.
Reese's peanut butter cups. Reese's peanut butter cups in any shape, form, whatever.
There you go.
I still like them. I'm not as into the candy anymore the older I get. There's only certain ones I like Mike and Ike's. That's my go-to candy, but I might not eat a full Three Musketeers, but if you give me a handful of them minis, and I'll sit there popping my pop.
You know, it's hard to, you know, or candy bars were always the thing. The Butterfinger, I see these. These are all good. These are all good, I'm telling you. Chocolate in general. I'm a chocolate guy. What's that?
Do they still make Mary Janes? You remember the Mary Janes? It was like that hard peanut butter candy.
There's a few places where they sell old time candy around here, and you can still find Mary Janes. I've seen them. Yeah, Mary Janes were good. I remember those, but they were just too chewy. After a while, you just get stuck. You're trying to pick it out of your teeth, and I used to like caramel squares, but they'd always get stuck everywhere. And I'm trying to pick my teeth, getting the caramel square out of my mouth. So,
I remember there was always that one old lady or old guy who gave out pennies.
I don't know, but yeah, I've gotten pennies a few times back in the day. Like, somebody gave me a box of raisins once. Like, she's just like, here you go, sir. Raisins, and I'm like, what? A box of raisins?
I used to eat raisins, man. Raisins is good. I don't know. I feel like raisins,
but it's Halloween. I want raisins or an apple or anything else. Give me some candy.
But
the difference,
old people were like, we're going to unload these pennies.
Right, here you go, sir.
But not only that, we were of the mindset and we had the upbringing that if Mrs. Johnson gave you a box of raisins, you said, thank you, happy Halloween.
I wasn't going to disrespect anyone, but yeah, I just went, oh, I got raisins. You know, after you go home, you're like, eh.
As soon as you got back down the path and turned, you're like, we got raisins. I got a rock.
100%.
My mother would text the hell out of my Halloween candy. Come here, baby. Let me see what you got. Mommy, eating all the good ones.
And your parents would set it to the side and be and then you never told them, even though they had to know, because if they looked at it, you knew where they were hiding it. You just went and grabbed it out and got it and stuff.
Yeah.
So yeah,
they weren't that conspicuous with it. You know what I mean? Like, come on, I know where the candy is. You don't fool me.
I don't think it was so much them trying to get down on our candy as it was them saving us from ourselves. Because if left to our own devices, we would devour the entire bag of candy
and be sick to our stomachs and throwing up and all that. They didn't
want to clean that up.
There was a reason for it. Yeah,
we were restricted to like three pieces. When we got home, you could have three pieces the first night. When we got home, they gave us three.
After they checked them to make sure. After trick or treating.
Oh yeah, for checking them for the razor blades, that the non-existent razor blades that people are supposedly
razor blades.
Yeah. Oh, now it's you gotta be careful because you gotta check your candy for the fentanyl.
No, it's the edibles that I laugh at. Listen, I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, the edibles.
Going off the rails, but I parent.
Don't we always? It's okay.
If you have never purchased edibles, they're very expensive.
Exactly.
You're not gonna give that shit away.
To your children.
No.
If they do get them, it's from their friends.
Yeah.
Not from adults.
Yeah, we talk about it. I must have got that from Mr. Johnson down the street.
They got them from their friends.
Didn't realize what they were.
They got them from their friends. Okay, that's
yeah. They're not cheap. That stuff is not cheap.
They're getting them from their friends. All right, that's who got it. But they don't want to get in trouble. Exactly. They don't want to get the friends in trouble. So they're gonna say, "Oh, I got them." Yeah, no. They didn't.
Ain't nobody giving you drugs in your trick-or-treat candy. Trust me, that stuff's too expensive. Ain't nobody giving you drugs. They're just going to give you candy and be on your merry way. Ain't nobody trying to give you their drugs. Well, listen.
Happy Halloween, thank you, everybody.
Happy Halloween. Thank you so much for watching.